How are you? It's Dr. Muso. Today we want to talk about the Land Apportionment Act. The whites in 1980, they apportioned the land. They divided the land. The whites were given a land. The Africans were also given a land. So today we want to look on the categories. We want to look on how this land was categorized, how this land was divided. So our question for today is identify five areas into which the Land Apportionment Act of 1980 was divided. How was land divided in 1980 through the so-called Land Apportionment Act? To apportion, like what I've said, it is to divide. So, number one, we see that there was a land which was known as the forest area or the dam reserve area. So, it was this land that was only reserved for forestry, land that was reserved for the wild animals. That land, it was not supposed to be touched. Why? It was reserved for forestry and it was also reserved for the wild animals. The elephants, the lions, they were supposed to enjoy to be in the jungle. And this was this so-called the game reserve area. There was also the native reserve water area. The natives, you're talking about the Africans, it was land that was reserved for the Africans. The Africans, they were supposed to stay in these native reserve water areas. There was also the European areas specifically for the wild. The Africans were not supposed to be seen in those areas. The whites, despite the fact that they were not many, they were allocated vast tracts of land. So they were the people who were supposed to utilize, they were the people who were supposed to use this land, they were the people who were supposed to enjoy this land. So we see the whites being given vast tracts of land. The European what are areas. There was also the native purchase areas, the areas where the Africans were supposed to purchase or to buy land. But Africans, were they in a position of buying land? They were not in that position of buying land. Why? They were facing so many challenges. They were so many facing severe challenges. They did not have the cash. They did not have the money. Remember, they paid so many taxes. They stayed in reserves where conditions were horrible. Conditions were terrible. They worked for the whites and they were not given adequate salaries. Their salaries were below poverty bottom line. A number of Africans, we see that they suffered during this particular period of time. So the whites, when they allocated, when they portioned this land, they knew that Africans were not going to be in a position of buying or purchasing land. Indirectly, it meant that they were going to take, they were going to possess this land. This land, it was going to be theirs. Why? It is because the Africans were not having the capabilities, the capacities to buy or to purchase the land. We also have got the unassigned areas. Assigned areas, we are talking about areas that were reserved for their unborn children. Areas that were specifically meant for their children who were not yet born. This one, the Land Apportionment Act. We see that it benefited the wife. It was meant to take as many what our land as possible from what our country and give it to the wife. So these were the areas for future determination. They were going to be determined. They were going to be reserved. They were only going to be given to the unborn white children. So this is how the land was divided, was apportioned through the so-called the Land Apportionment Act of 1980. Thank you so much. It's Dr. Muso.